journal paintings are a series of small A5-ish paintings that that I did in 1978. And I traveled through Peru and Bolivia and Brazil, and then over to Portugal and Spain, and in the end to England. And during the time of these travels, I visited some incredible places. Lived in a tiny village called Palepuera on near Maceió in the Alagoas in the northeast of Brazil. Madrid in Spain and Santiago de Compostela in Galicia, where I lived for a spell. In places I just did these tiny paintings that are like little colourful glimpses of where I was and probably how I felt as well. They've sat inside that journal for so many years, and so for the very first time I took them out and had them framed up, and just they're the journal paintings now, and they exist. Well, Lime Tree Cottage was the name of an old house in a village called Aslacton in Norfolk in England, where I lived while I was working at the Norwich Art Centre for a couple of years. And that's where, when I first met Dougie, he moved in with me there, and it was the beginning of the idea of having our own publishing company and record label. I think all of that started in good old Lime Tree Cottage. And I also did my first off-loom weavings on pieces of wood with amazing golden and brown colours, and I just did this. That was the first, I think probably the first weaving that I was really, really proud of was called Wood, and that was done in Lime Tree Cottage. In about, when would it have been? 1982, we recorded the first album of Dougie's songs and tunes on what was to become our Dunkeld Records label. And we decided to put a painting of mine that I'd done of the cottage that we were living in, which was called Craigie Doo Cottage, on the front cover. And then the album became Craigie Doo. And a style of albums that we then used for a while, which had one of my paintings in some way on the cover of Dougie's albums, happened. And it's amazing how over the years there's been a real connection between his music and my paintings for Dougie's audiences, and people seem to enjoy both these days. Thank you. the diversity of Scotland is just, I find, extraordinary. The four seasons, the ancient buildings, the diverse landscape from, you know, coastal oceans to inland Scotland, Perthshire, where we live with the lochs and rivers and mountains and moors. It's an amazing country. And, you know, up to the highlands and islands. So the diversity is what I was hoping to catch in bringing that section of paintings together. Scotland's my home, has been now for over 40 years, and it's an amazing place. By the middle of 2020, when we all realised that the COVID pandemic was a pretty serious thing and that we could well be in lockdown for quite a while, Diggy and I were doing broadcasts quite regularly here from the old schoolhouse, and I was just doing loads of spinning and dyeing from natural sources that I could find around the property because we weren't going far from home. And so I was dyeing with black currants and red currants and beans and all sorts of things that were growing in the garden. I tried lettuce. And I tried pea pods, I remember that was a good dye source. And so I was spinning lots and dyeing, and then discovered these two old parts of one of the original Butterston windows. And so I proceeded to strip them both back and string them up in preparation for a weaving. So I wove behind the window and it ended up being two weavings that I'm really pleased with. One loosely based on colours and forms from around here, and the other just reminded me a touch of Australia and the colours and the feel of the outback there, and so I called them Home and Away. I'll always call myself Australian, even though Scotland has become my home. I don't think I'll ever get rid of my Australian accent, and I absolutely love getting back to Australia and seeing the family. I've got a huge family still over there, and exploring different parts of that huge and diverse country. You know, luckily over the years, Dougie and I have been able to get back to Australia really often, in fact. You know, every 3 or 4 years. Quite often for tours or festivals, but always we've managed to fit in a journey, a little exploration to somewhere new. And it's certainly a fascinating and very beautiful country that I will always return to as often as I can. Potterston Garden is really a very important part of my life, and has been for quite a few years. Dougie's dad, who was a gardener, first taught me a little bit about the difference between gardening in Australia to gardening in Scotland. I was really, really frustrated by the time I took things to grow here. But now I'm much more patient and I enjoy all the seasons and the flowers that they bring. Has been truly inspirational. There's something about the rugged rocks along the coastline and the huge skies that even though the climate's really different, it does remind me of Australia. There's just something about it, about the expanse of sky and I guess the ocean as well. And so it's inspired my most recent work. I've been inspired by reef, beach, and the surrounding islands and coastline.